Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this ropes and pulleys problem, we have this 500 kilogram piano. So the mass is 500 kilograms. And then we're lowering it down by these ropes here. And they tell us that Ellen's rope has an angle of 25 degrees below the horizontal. And then Bob's rope is 15 below the horizontal. So we'll say that Bob's rope, we'll say, is theta 1, and that's 15 degrees. And then Ellen's rope is theta 2, which we said is 25 degrees. And that Bob's rope is pulling with 500 newtons of tension. So we'll say tension 1 for Bob's rope is 500 newtons of force. And for A, we need to figure out how much tension Ellen needs to have in her rope to keep the piano descending vertically at a constant speed. And then for part B, we need to figure out what the tension is in the vertical main cable supporting the piano. I always like to do a free body diagram first off, just to better visualize what's happening. So right here, we'll say this is the rope, and let's label that one T3. That's what we're going to find for part B. And then we have T1 for Bob, and below the horizontal, they tell us that that angle is 15 degrees. And then for Ellen, her angle is 25 degrees, so this was theta 1 and theta 2. We also have the weight of the piano coming straight down. So for part A, what we're looking for is, of course, the tension 2 for Ellen's rope right here. So that's T2, this is T1, and this is T3. So for T2, let's first sum the forces in the x direction. So sum of the forces in the x, and the piano is moving, but it's moving at a constant velocity, so it will be in dynamic equilibrium, so this will be equal to zero. So we have T1 plus T2 is equal to zero, because as we said, in the x direction, it's not speeding up or slowing down, so it's in dynamic equilibrium. So for T1, we have in the x direction, this right here, so that is going to be adjacent to the angle, and then right here for Ellen's rope, it's also adjacent to the angle. So for T1, it's going in the negative x direction, so we have a negative T1 times the cosine of the angle theta 1, and then for T2, it's going in the positive x direction, so T2 cosine of theta 2 is equal to zero. We want to solve this for T2, so let's first add this over to the other side. So now we have T2 cosine of theta 2 is equal to a positive now, T1 cosine of theta 1. To isolate T2, we'll just divide by cosine of theta 2. So now we have T2 is equal to, rewrite that over here just for being thorough. So now T1 cosine of theta 1 divided by cosine of theta 2 is equal to Ellen's tension. So T1, Bob's, is 550 newtons. And then we're times by the cosine of 15 degrees for theta 1. We'll divide all of that by cosine of theta 2, which is 25 degrees. So we have 550 cosine of 15 divided by cosine of 25. So T2 will be equal to, oops, so I just caught myself that I just made a mistake early on. We said it was 550 newtons. That is 500. Watching the video, you're probably thinking, what in the world is he doing? So this is just a good example of having a list of all the variables and doing everything algebraically first. You can catch simple mistakes like this. That should be 500 newtons. So now when we come to the calculator, now we can plug all this in. I already plugged it in once when I caught myself. So that is 500 cosine 15 divided by cosine of 25. So that is going to be 533 newtons. So we'll keep that at two significant figures. So 530 newtons for the tension 2. So now going to part B, we need to figure out what is the tension in the vertical main cable supporting the piano. So for B, we need to find T3. To find T3, now we can sum the forces in the y direction. Let's come up here just for space. So we have sum of the forces in the y direction is equal to T1. So sum of the forces in the y direction is equal to the y component of T1. plus the y component of t2 plus the y component of t3, which is only y component for 3, plus the weight now is equal to 0, as we already talked about, is in dynamic equilibrium. So for t1, the y component now is going to be opposite of the angle for both of t1 and t2. So we have a negative, because it's in the negative y direction, so negative t1 sine of 15 plus t2 is equal to a negative t2 sine of 25 degrees. And then we're going to add t3, and then we're going to add weight is mg, and that's all equal to 0. So let's subtract all these over to give us isolated for t3. And so we have a t3 is equal to, this will now be positive, so we have positive t1 sine of 15 plus a positive t2 sine of 25. And then we're going to subtract over mg, but mg is already negative, so really this should be a negative mg. So that will also be positive when we move it over. And then the mass, well, let's put mg first and we'll plug everything in. Okay, so now we have t3 is equal to t1, which we said is 500 times the sine of 15 plus t2 is, we found, was 530 sine of 25 degrees plus the weight is the mass, 500 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared, and that's kilograms. All right, so we have 500 sine of 15 plus 530. You could put 532 if you want, times sine of 25. Oops, another parentheses right here. So there we go. 530 sine 25 plus the weight we said is 500 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared. So we have 5253. So we could round that to 5,300 for two significant figures. So we have 5,300 newtons for the tension in the vertical rope for T3.